Now, we have a different picture. This is just something that's lying on top of his chest. We're just checking the position of the catheters. Now here, this has come up from the vein of his leg. Remember, this is the vein of the leg. Now this has come up. So we're in his heart here. Where's it going through here? If it's coming through a vein, what do we call that vein?
Superior?
No, superior is up north. This is superior. Which one?
Inferior.
Exactly. Good job. Yeah. Inferior vena cava into the right atrium. And then I'm injecting diadone, which what this is clear. This is like clear liquid.
Mm-hmm.
But it has iodine in it, which is a big nucleus, and so it blocks X-ray. All these pictures are taken with X-ray. So I'm injecting this through this. It's a tube. And it's all going back this way. What do you think I'm pushing against right here if I'm in the right atrium? Why don't we get our heart? And why don't we look? So if I'm pushing against, I came up here, I'm pushing against here, what's on the other side of here? Figure it out. Pushing here.
Pushing here? You mean that good side that I can hear it?
No.
No, because it's pushing on the wall.
Oh.
Yeah, exactly, pushing on the wall. Excellent.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's the septum. That's called the atrial septum. Septum just means wall.
Mm-hmm.
Like a curtain. So we're pushing there. Now why would we be pushing there? We got all these cool things to do. There's all this great TV at home. There's all these things. Why don't I want to just go up against a wall and push? Like, would we walk here and just push our noses against the wall?
Maybe you'll see maybe how strong the baby is.
Yeah, I want to poke my way through it. Mm-hmm. And so temporarily, I poke my way through it, and that's what I just did. And now what atrium am I in?
Mm-hmm. So you're looking here. And you poked into this.
Come back, come over. This way, right back here. Mm-hmm. So I'm in this atrium.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
What do we call that atrium? If that's the right atrium?
That was the left atrium.
Right. And I actually went out one of the veins. This is a vein from the lung. You know it's a vein because do you see how blood is coming back to the heart?
Mm-hmm.
And we said veins
mm-hmm.
comes to the heart and arteries.
Carry the blood away?
Exactly. You know it all. Forget it. I'll stop asking. And this is a side view of the same thing. So we're in a vein of the lung. They can't see anything unless you put dye in or unless it's bone. Otherwise, you can't see stuff. So then I put this really big tube in. And then I'm injecting. And now you see this is a vein from the lungs. We call it a pulmonary vein. And this is the left, what?
Atrium.
Exactly. And then it goes into the left, right here. So what's that called?
The left.
And this is from the side. So then, you see really well, left atrium, we'll just stop this. So this is a part of the left atrium, left ventricle, and then it's going to go out here. Watch. And that little blush, that's the aorta. See the little blush there?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's cool. So we're fussing around, having a good time. This came from the arm, and this came down the superior.
Superior artery?
Or arteries go from
ventricles.
No, superior vena cava.
Vena cava.
And then it went through the right atrium. And now I took a picture in the right ventricle. Let's look at this. Look really slow. Forget about that. That's when it's already in the left.
It looks like a heartbeat.
Yeah, the heart's literally beating. So we're injecting this in the right ventricle. Let's look at our heart. So we're injecting here, and it's going to go out here. We put our hand like that, so it's in the right ventricle. It's going to go out to which? Is it going to go to the body or to the lungs?
Is it going to go to your lung, right?
Right. So you're just about to see that it'll fill the arteries of the lung. That's the pulmonary artery. Okay. Now, what's already starting to come back on the other side and fill the left ventricle. Wait a second. Now it's the left ventricle that's being filled, and now it's going to the aorta, which is the artery to the bottom. But there's something funny here. Look at this. It doesn't make sense.
Oh yeah, why isn't that one?
Wait a second, don't steal my thumb. What's going on? It's supposed to just light up the lungs, but almost immediately it lit up the aorta. What's going on? Did it magically appear somewhere else? Like when your sister happens to have one of your toys, and she says, it just magically appeared in my room.
My sister's older than me,
I have two daughters, and if they would both get a doll, the little ones would magically appear in the other one's room all the time, because she stole it. There's no magic here. So why do you think it's suddenly appearing? Even though we're injecting here, it's appearing up here. What's going on?
Maybe the knees are carrying it up there.
Could be, but we know that there was no opening there because I had to push something through.
Oh yeah, when that take it, the blood would keep going through it.
Could be, but we didn't give it enough time. What it actually is this heart is missing this big hunk of muscle. So talk about a wall being a septum. This heart is missing the ventricular septum, or piece of it. And that's like a general heart defect, and I'll show you more. So this should be just filling up, this is from the side, just filling up the pulmonary artery. But from the very beginning, you see a little whiff filling the aorta. Now we'll go to that picture that we're talking about. Well, this is just a picture of the pulmonary artery. Superior vena cava, right atrium, right ventricle, in the pulmonary artery, and then it's the left ventricle, left atrium. We'll just go to the picture I wanted to show you. So now where is this catheter? It's going to cross the septum in the atrium, and it's in the left ventricle. So we're going to cross this wall to here, and down to here. Okay, so we took a picture of it. Why would we do this? Why would any smart mother say, oh, please, Dr. Abadia, go ahead, take pictures of my baby's heart. Why do you think they do that?
Because it's a good disorder and they want to fix it.
Exactly. And this baby was very swollen and very weak and very tired. And as soon as this baby would start eating or drinking, he'd be huffing and puffing. And because he had this extra hole in his heart, we showed you. So I'm filling the left ventricle, but look, blood's flowing straight across to the right ventricle.
And you have a heart muscle, like the middle one.
Exactly.
That's so strong.
It's supposed to be just muscle here. It's supposed to be muscle all the way here. But is it? No.
Yeah.
It's a big hole there. That counts as big. So here, you see how thick the muscle is supposed to be? Right ventricle, left ventricle, and just missing. All that stuff is missing. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Do you guys see that?
Mm-hmm.
So that baby, I had Dr. Obawi, who's an excellent surgeon, who's from Homs. Mm-hmm. In Lebanon, is that in Lebanon? That's Syria.
Syria.
Yeah. But he's so funny. He always says he's from Lebanon. And so the surgeon, he's really from Syria, but he says he's from Lebanon. So I was invited to give a talk in Beirut, and I finally figured out that he wasn't telling the truth. So I couldn't understand it, and I still don't understand why you'd say you're from Lebanon when you're from Homs. But I'm sure there's some history. But I thought it was really funny. So, he fixed that hole. He's an amazing surgeon. See, good surgeons are from Syria, so you better get cracking. Now I'll show you another kit. It's see if you guys.